If you think you are safe on the blockchain, think again. You're constantly being watched and it's not safe. If you care about your privacy and the safety of your assets, please, please, please watch till the end of this video.
Cryptonauts.
One way to get wrecked on-chain is called a sandwich attack. No, it's not the one where you throw sandwiches at each other. It might be pretty fun. It's like pillow fights, but not really. You're getting hungry, actually. Oh man, can't wait to eat the sandwich.
I'm super hungry. I haven't eaten anything, so.
Anyways, the truth is, when you trade on DEXs, you're always losing out to bots. When you execute a trade, a bot front runs your trade by buying the tokens right before your transaction is mined. This increases the price, making you buy for a higher price. The result is that you overpay for your tokens, and bots profited by selling the tokens after your purchase transaction is mined. It's called a sandwich attack because your original pending transaction is sandwiched between the bot's orders.
Sandwich attack.
Each transaction is sent to a public meme pool, which everyone can see. And bots, being quick enough, can exploit that. There's nothing much we can do about it because that's just the public nature of blockchains.
How can we stop it?
It's too late, it's happened.
Unless your wallet has some sort of protection built in to avoid this. Did you know that your personal data is exposed whenever you connect to a dApp? Here's how it works. Your wallet cannot interact with the blockchain directly. It can only do that through nodes. So each step you make actually goes through the companies that run these nodes. Each time you connect to a dApp, make a transaction, or deposit funds to a protocol, the request is sent to a node, which verifies and executes the transaction. But what you don't know is that these node requests are full of juicy data like your IP address, web browser version, and so on. These node providers who deploy and run the nodes can see all of this data. They practically know where you are right now.
Nope, can't see me, I'm too fast.
I was shocked to learn that node providers can access our personal information. The worst part is that they don't even need it to execute the transactions. Now, obviously, your data remains at the node company. They have policies not to share them with third parties, and it's generally safe. But what if that company gets hacked? What if Uncle Sam comes? What if the company is acquired by some shady organization? That's when your personal information is out in the open. Oh, and they can ban you from accessing the blockchain since they control the nodes. Pretty scary, huh? Perhaps crypto wallets are not as decentralized as you think, except for privacy-focused wallets such as BlockWallet. All right, let's talk about phishing attacks. It is the oldest play in the book, the bread and butter of Web3 scammers. They work by tricking victims with fake error messages, wallet pop-ups, or impersonating well-known brands asking you to verify your credentials. They will then lead you to unofficial websites or extensions that would expose your wallet seed phrase or other sensitive info. You'd think people should be more careful about connecting to shady websites, but the truth is both crypto newbies and veterans still fall victim to these, till this day. In just 2021 alone, phishers reportedly stole a whopping $14 billion worth of funds, which is twice as much as the $7.8 billion in 2020. And take Todd Kramer and Larry Lawliot, for example. Both NFT whales had several of their Bored Ape NFTs worth millions of dollars stolen from a phishing scam. That's pretty profitable. But as crypto evolves, so do hackers and scammers. They can make phishing sites look incredibly legit. They can even copy the domains of well-known wallets and dApps with slight moderations to it. And you won't even notice the difference, which is why you always, 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 always have to double check the link that you are clicking to make sure that it is indeed the right one. Flexing that ENS domain or an NFT profile pic on Twitter. Twitter? That's cool. But did you consider that you are also doxing all of your wallet addresses if you're not careful? If you don't know, an Ethereum name service, aka ENS, is a simple name that replaces your complicated Ethereum wallet address, making it easier to send and receive crypto. For example, instead of my wallet address 0x blah 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 blah, you would see something like cookie.eth or sandwich.eth. And NFTs, well, you probably don't need me explaining to you what an NFT is. Since most blockchains are open and transparent, anyone can use your Ethereum name or NFT to snoop on your finances. It's the difference between sending someone an email and them being able to look at your entire inbox. It's really simple. Each ENS domain and NFT has a wallet address attached to it. Even if you don't use your main wallet address to register your ENS or mint that NFT, it's so easy to trace this address back to your other addresses. The problem is that when you let others know that this ENS or NFT belongs to you, you might get some unwanted attention, let's say from scammers. If you were to flex your super expensive Bored Ape NFT as your Twitter profile picture, you'd put a target on your back. And if they see that there's stuff to steal from you, they can go to great lengths to make that happen. Okay, so all this stuff is pretty scary, but the good news is that you can actually do something about it.
Whoa, what's happening? Oh yeah, our friends at BlockWallet turned on their privacy thing again. Guys, it's okay, let's switch it off for now.
Do you trade on DEXs, use DeFi protocols? You better be careful out there. If you want to stay safe on chain, then you need BlockWallet. BlockWallet is the first self-custodial Web3 wallet that actually cares about you and protects you. Node providers won't see any of your personal data when you use BlockWallet because they remove all that information before sending it to the nodes. If you're tired of losing out to bots, I know I am, look no further. Use BlockWallet's flash bot protection feature to send your trades to a private mempool where no bots will be able to see your transaction and front run you. Simple as that, you'll buy crypto cheaper. Oh, there's more. BlockWallet is not a compromise. Using phishing protection, connect to any dApp, connect hardware wallets, enjoy the experience. BlockWallet is available on Chrome or Brave browser today. Check out blockwallet.io or click the link in the description. So, have you ever been wrecked by any of the things that we've discussed previously? Or are there any other privacy risks that you think we should be aware of? Please let us know in the comments. If you like this video, smash that like button and subscribe. As always, remember to HODL, secure crypto, and may Satoshi and Vitalik be with you always. I'm gonna eat this sandwich now. I'm waiting all day. Should talk about sandwich attacks more.